Tyler here. Welcome to TokenCast. This week, I'm reviewing Metroid Other M for the Nintendo Wii. For anyone who's never played a Metroid game, you probably don't know that much about the main character and heroine, Samus Aran. Metroid Other M seeks to remedy that. Other M takes place immediately following Super Metroid for the SNES, and is also Samus' first speaking role. Through the events of the game, we learn the truth about parts of Samus' past with the Federation, why she left, and of course, information about her few friends left in the galaxy. Other M's story plays like an interactive movie, and after Nintendo got burned by the utter failure that was the Super Mario Bros. Movie, I don't see them taking a chance on feature films again anytime soon. Other M is the Metroid movie fans have been wanting since they first set foot on planet Zebes in 1986. Unfortunately, the story does not touch on Samus' childhood. It only alludes to the fact that Ridley killed her parents, and the Chozo are not mentioned once. Kind of a big oversight. Also, the story does not tie up everything nicely. For instance, when members of the Federation team that Samus is aiding are found assassinated, Samus nicknames a traitor in their midst the Deleter. This person's identity is never revealed, though, a somewhat upsetting outcome. This guy is supposed to be a big, important character, yet we never learn his identity? It's a small part of the overall story arc, but they have so many story arcs going at once, some relevant to the current mission, some regarding Samus' past, that it can get a little confusing. You really have to pay attention. If you've ever played Super Paper Mario, you've played the Wii Remote position switch gameplay style. Hold the Wii Remote sideways to control Samus in third person, and turn it toward the screen to get some Metroid Prime-style first-person shooting. Samus cannot move in first person, however, so you need to make sure that you've incapacitated your enemies, or at least that you have some distance between them. However, the switch between viewpoints is absolutely seamless. There's no lag between them, and although you can only fire missiles in first person, it adds an interesting gameplay element without hindering the difficulty or the frame rate. Despite minor slowdowns and huge firefights, the Wii handles this behemoth of a game very well. I know it's kind of a bad thing to say it looks good for the Wii, but Metroid Other M looks good for any console game. It quite honestly defies the graphical limitations of the console. Kudos to Team Ninja for overcoming a hardware deficiency, just like Rare used to do with the N64 back in the 90s. Most all of Samus' memorable suit upgrades are in Other M, but unlike previous installments, Samus does not lose them at the beginning of the game due to some severe trauma to her power suit. Instead, her upgrades are tied to the story, and are recovered as you progress through the story, and are authorized by Samus' temporary commanding officer, Adam Malkovich, a name which players of Metroid Fusion no doubt remember. The overall sense of guided exploration found in other Metroid games is still very much evident, but like Prime, you're mostly going from event to event, cutscene to cutscene, and blasting enemies in between. This element, however, does not detract from the overall experience. It enhances it. Overall, Other M doesn't feel like an outsider to the series. It plays and feels like any other Metroid installment, with creepy and dark overtones peppered in with suspense and surprise around every corner. Heck, the game even requires intense reflexes to utilize Samus' reflex moves as a counterattack, as well as to counter enemies that pop out at you to avoid damage, or even death in some situations. Fortunately, the game slows down in these instances, on purpose I mean, to allow for a minor reaction delay due to surprise or soiled underwear. Voiced by the actress Jessica Martin, Samus' first true speaking role allows us more access and insight into her past than ever before. Unfortunately, Nintendo is notorious for having primarily mute protagonists, a trend which has begun to decrease but is still prominent with characters like Mario, Link, Kirby, and Captain Olimar, to name a few. Samus has always been a sort of quiet enigma, but a figure who has always invited many inquiries about her past and personality. Other M secures Samus' position as one of Nintendo's lone characters with humanity, emotions, and empathy, traits which I, for one, would love to see expanded upon in all of their lead characters. The depth of Samus' story may not be worth the title of Final Fantasy story level, but it's certainly worth understanding if you're as interested in Samus as a person as I am. Let's hope that her days of silently blasting space pirates are over, and that we will continue to gain insight into both her past and her present. Although Other M is somewhat short, it's an unforgettable experience and a must-play for fans of Metroid and Miss Aran alike. If you enjoyed the first-person gameplay of the Prime series, you'll like Other M, and if you're like me and felt stuck inside Samus' helmet and switched to Morph Ball mode just for a respite, you'll love Other M even more. Unfortunately, the Wii's processor can't always handle the level of particle effects and polygons on screen at any given moment, and will rarely, but annoyingly, slow down and cause the frame rate to chug. If this were any other game, I'd say put it on a PC and problem solved, but this is Nintendo, so let's just hope their next console has a better processor and graphics card. Also, it can get frustrating at times for players who are unfamiliar with the Metroid series gameplay, and sometimes relies on nostalgia to defeat certain enemies. For instance, if you've never played Metroid before, how should you know that to defeat a Metroid hatchling, you must freeze it and then use a missile on it before it breaks free, much less when seven are attacking you along with a Metroid Queen? Lastly, the story can get a bit confusing since there are so many story arcs going on at the same time. You've got the A story arc of what's going on in the current mission, the B story arc of this guy, the Deleter, and numerous others including Samus's past, why are there Metroids here if they're supposed to be extinct, and who is this other chick we're looking for, Madeline Bergman? Well, only the Deleter thing was really left unanswered, so there's really only one loose end hanging, really. On the upside, this is essentially the interactive Metroid movie. However, it retains the gameplay and atmosphere of any other Metroid game. A major pro is the deep insight into Samus' psyche and her personal history, and let's not forget the satisfaction of blasting the crap out of Samus' old nemesis, Ridley. Come on, did you really think he was going to sit this one out? My Two Tokens gives Metroid Other M for the Nintendo Wii 9 stars out of 10. Whether you've only gotten a glimpse of her in Smash Bros., or you're a longtime fan of the series, Metroid Other M is a genuine can't-miss experience with intriguing characters, engrossing gameplay, and a level of humanity given to an enigmatic character who was once shrouded in mystery. Samus is now more human than ever, and I for one am overjoyed that she has become a relatable character. It's about time Nintendo had at least one. This is Tyler of My Two Tokens, signing off. Thanks for listening.